Yes, today we will see the development of tray. Tray front view is something like this. This size is 60 millimeter. This angle is 45 degree. This 45 degree and height is suppose 25 mm. And its top view is like this. This is of 70. And here 30. Above 30. This tray is joined like this. Okay. So when the tray opens, this wall is like this and this wall is like this. So when you open the tray will be like this. And here this wall will be touches to the ground, it will be like this. So means this will go away, this will away, this will away. So when this tray opens, so what will happen? This wall will touches to the ground like this. And project this. So this wall will be here. Similarly, on the right hand side, this wall touches the ground. So this wall will be like this. Okay. Tray wall inclined at an angle of 45 degree, then it is touches to the ground. Okay. Now this will go forward. So how it will be drawn? That we will see. So take center this one. Suppose this is A, B, C and D. So center D, radius equal to this much, draw an arc. And where this intersect to the original, you have to draw the line like this. So when the wall opens, we will obtain V shape will obtain. Similarly here center A, radius equal to this much, draw an arc. Where this intersect here, so this V and join this like this. So this will be the front wall, back wall, right side wall and left hand side wall. So repeat the procedure here also, center B, radius equal to this much, draw an arc. Where this intersect, that is this V shape. Similarly here also, center C, radius equal to this much, draw an arc. Where this intersect, you will get V. Like this, and this back wall will be joined like this. So this will be the development of tray. Okay, symmetrical tray you can say, and angle is 45-45. If the tray is not symmetrical, so I am taking another example here. So if the tray is not symmetrical means. Suppose this is 60 and height is 30, this is 30 and here the angle is 30 degree, 45 degree like this, and here the angle is 60 degree. So this tray is not symmetrical one, as in previous case 45 45, this angle is 60 and this angle is 45. So in such case, how this development of tray will be drawn? So same procedure, project this, and this size will be given to you, of course. So this is of 70. This is the inner side of the tray, and this is the original position of the wall. Okay, and here this 30 is given, here 30 is given, and this is the original top view of the tray. I am making this outer side fin because after development the wall will go forward to the right, left, and wall will increase to the up and down also. So same procedure means this wall will come down to the ground. This will be projected and this wall will be like this. Okay. Similarly, on the right hand side, this center radius this much. Draw an arc to the ground and project this. So this wall will be like this. Okay. Then again, same procedure, that is A, B, C, D. So center D, radius equal to this much, draw an arc where this intersect. So we will get a V like this. So V, then similarly here also, center A, radius equal to this much, draw an arc, again form a V. This V, then center B, radius equal to this much, draw an arc. So here also you will get V, this V, then this center C, radius equal to this much, draw an arc. So you will get this V, this V. Now join this bottom side flap and this upper side flap. The difference between these two tray is, here the angle is 45 and here the angle is different one. 45 and 60, angle may be 30, 60, angle may be any other angle, but procedure will be same. So this side is a bigger one, this side will be smaller one due to angle. Okay, so draw these two problems on your sketchbook. Our next chapter, intersection of surfaces, we will start in next lecture. Okay.